To improve the efficiency and quality of your design, we have added a new powerful feature, template in V6.9.1. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create a template window, create template objects and test them through online simulation. Template streamlines your workflow, allowing you to create objects quickly, reducing repetitive tasks and errors. With template, you can define rules for tag name mapping and text mapping, making it easy to create commonly used displays, such as cylinders, valves, shafts, and more. As you compile the project, the system automatically generates objects based on your rules, updating the corresponding tags and text. This time-saving feature lets you focus more on the logic and aesthetics of your design. Using templates is simple and only requires a few steps. Begin by opening your project in EasyBuilder Pro and select a window to use as the template. For this demo, let's use window 20 as an example. Within window 20, I added some objects. You may find similar tags in the PLC tag list. To simplify, I assigned all numeric related objects to data underscore block underscore 1 int underscore 0 and assigned boolean related object to data underscore block underscore 1 bool underscore 0. Next, set text and combo as keywords for comment content. This expedites text replacement within the template using text mapping rules. In the toolbar, click the template button's drop-down menu to access the settings window, and add window 20 as the template window. Return to the main display window, window 10, and click template in the toolbar to add a template object. Clicking on the template opens a setup window. Here, you can define tag name mapping and text mapping rules for a template window. In this example, three template objects have been added. For the first template object, let's keep the tag mapping table untouched and only configure the text mappings. For the second template object, let's add a new tag mapping rule, replacing data underscore block underscore 1 with data underscore block underscore 2 in the tag names, and set tank 2 as the text mapping rule. For the third template object, let's modify the tag mapping rule to replace bool underscore 0 with bool underscore 1 and int underscore 0 with int underscore 1 in the tag names, and set tank 3 as the text mapping rule. You have already observed the outcome of text mapping on the screen. With the template object, you only need to make adjustments within the template window. As a result, all related template objects will be simultaneously updated. For example, if you alter the image and color of a bit lamp object, all related template objects in window 10 will reflect these changes. You can add these template objects to the operation log through operation log settings in the data history tab of the toolbar, and place an operation log view object on the screen to monitor the results of text mapping. Now, let's proceed to an online simulation. The system automatically generates objects according to your template and rules when compiling the project. You'll see that the objects are correctly mapped to their respective tags after tag mapping. And you can review the results of text mapping in the operation log view object. Thank you for watching this introduction to templates. We hope you find this feature valuable and consider giving it a try.